Hi, we are at the Moot Court of Manik Chandpade Law College in Chhatrapati Sambhajinagar, Maharashtra. This hall is called late L.S. Kulkarni Memorial Moot Court Hall. This video is a walkthrough of this hall. In this video, we will discuss what are the client requirements and how we have designed the hall accordingly. So let's get right to it. I am Amod from Consonance Acoustics. We are an acoustical products and consultation company. MP Law College got in touch with us because they wanted to have this ready structure converted into a moot court hall. A key thing for them was to ensure speech clarity because moot courts are a critical part of the curriculum for law students. They also wanted to avoid any external noises coming from outside of this hall. There's a road very close by, so they wanted to avoid the traffic noise. They wanted this space to resemble an actual court as much as possible so that the students can get a feel of a proper court. So there is a proper judge area, there is an area for the clerks, there are podiums for the lawyers to argue, there's also a witness box here. And we also have a viewing area for other students to watch this competition. And the electronics are designed in such a way that they could also host presentation competitions if they want to, because it becomes a multi-purpose hall after that. Let me show you how we approached designing of this hall. To ensure speech clarity, we need to absorb frequencies from 125 Hz to 8000 Hz. We need to have a balanced reverberation time. I've created another video that explains this concept. You can watch it afterwards. The links are in the description. Now, in a hall like this, what is the main source of absorption for frequencies above 500 Hz? Usually the audience. You can see that the chairs are upholstered and cushioned, so they will absorb everything above 500 Hz. The question remains, how do you absorb lower frequencies? So you can see that we've installed our patented low frequency absorbers on the corner of this hall. Now it mimics the beams. So it adds to the interior design. It's a very non-intrusive installation. And it does the job of absorbing lower frequencies, which ensures a really good speech clarity. Now to ensure sound insulation from the road outside, we've come up with these windows. They already had these sliding glass windows in place. They did not want to spend a lot on removing them and installing different DGUs. So what we did was, we treated that glass window as one surface. We have a layer of rock wool here, and then there is an SDMR sheet outside. So when we close this window, it mimics a sandwich structure. We've experienced really good insertion loss from this sort of a construction. To ensure this resembles a courtroom as much as possible, we've created this separation here. The purpose of this is to separate the audience area and the court proceedings. What it does is, it establishes an authority for the courtroom. It helps create this boundary for the students. This separation has a two-way spring door. And it is made of Australian teak wood.
On the audience side of the hall, we have these shisham wood sofas to host the dignitaries attending events and upholstered chairs for students attending the events. Coming to this side of the divider, we have these podiums for the students who present their arguments.
We have this table which resembles the clerk table. It also doubles down as a place for the operator to control the AV of the space. Now we have this witness box, which is again made using Australian teak. It's not strictly a part of the moot court curriculum, but its presence creates the aura of a courtroom, which I think is essential for this space. So for the judges' chairs, we have these traditional wooden chairs, and we've engraved the national emblem on them.
The stage backdrop finish is created using polished teak veneer on the base of SDHMR sheets for longevity. The national emblem on the backdrop is made using laser-cut acrylic sheets. The stage wall has a single door that leads to the green room of the hall, which is an entry for the judges. This door was concealed in the stage backdrop design using these decorative door handles that are installed symmetrically on the backdrop. So the person sitting on this clerk table will use this computer to control a lot of the audio video. We can have a camera here which will stream images to the five screens. Now this is a very long haul, so we want to ensure visibility of all the activities that are happening. So the camera can stream the images of the judges or the podiums to all these five screens that are installed. And additionally, this person can also showcase presentations from this computer. So let me talk a bit about the audio system here. We have these ceiling speakers that are installed all across the hall. Now, what they do is they propagate the sound downwards. We don't want the sound to travel to the back wall and reflect again. That causes some late reflections, which are bad for speech clarity. These speakers, when they propagate the sound, it will get absorbed by the audience here. That will ensure a lot of crisp and clear speech. Now, we have these microphones here for the podium. These microphones have a lot of polar patterns. Now, these polar patterns help reduce the chance of any feedback that can happen from these speakers and the mic. So that brings us to the end of this video. Please share this with people you think will find this interesting. And if you want to watch more of such videos, please subscribe. Thank you, and bye for now.